Ants are among the most remarkable creatures on our planet. Despite their tiny size, they play a crucial role in ecosystems, maintaining balance and ensuring soil health. These tiny insects form complex colonies where each individual plays a unique role. From workers carrying food to defenders guarding the nest, ants are a team working together for the common good. Their colonies can consist of a million or more individuals, organized into a complex social structure where everyone works for the survival and prosperity of the community. But not all ants are the same in their intentions and goals. Some species have chosen the more aggressive and manipulative path to dominance. They have turned their lives into a constant pursuit of subjugating other colonies and exploiting their resources. As we dive into this fascinating world, we will uncover how these seemingly insignificant creatures can pose a threat to their neighbors. Take a closer look. What if everything we know about friendly ants is just the tip of the iceberg in their complex universe? In the world of ants, there is an astonishing phenomenon that at first glance seems fantastical. It is slavery. Slave-making ants don't just abduct other ants. They launch real raids on neighboring colonies not to destroy, but to capture. These tiny strategies display extraordinary cunning and coordination, directing their forces toward capturing outsiders. As soon as the prey falls into their clutches, a process of social reorganization begins on that the insects carry out on a purely instinctive level. The instincts of these ants are so precisely developed that once in a new colony, the slaves begin to perform all internal duties from caring for the brood to maintaining cleanliness and order. The biological basis of this phenomenon lies in chemical exchange and pheromonal deception, which allow the captors to control the behavior of their prisoners. How does the strategy of these tiny invading overseers work, and how do they manage to reprogram their captives, creating a balanced workforce from the individuals they have seized? Very soon, we will delve even deeper into this dark side of nature and see how such an order of things leads to the successful development of their unusual colonies. Slave-making ants are true masters of strategy and manipulation in the insect world. And, of course, there are key players among them. One such species is Poriegus breviceps, sometimes called Amazon ants. Their bright red bodies and dense woolly coverings make them stand out easily among others. These ants can organize raids on neighboring Formica colonies without hesitation to replenish their ranks with slaves. It's also worth mentioning Formica sanguine ants, known for their versatility. They not only successfully enslave other colonies, but are also able to adapt to various conditions, ensuring their survival and control over new territories. Although these species share similar goals, their strategies and living conditions can differ significantly. For example, Tetramorium inquilinum operates more covertly, preferring to infiltrate and remain inside the colonies of their victims for extended periods. They do not attack openly, but instead participate in the social structures of their target, gradually taking over their internal resources. These species represent only a small part of the astonishing biodiversity of slave-making ants, but their methods of control and enslavement do not end there. Ahead of us lie even more discoveries about their fascinating tactics and strategies. What can we learn when we dig even deeper into their behavior? The answer lies in their remarkable capture strategies. Life is like war. That's how you could describe the approach slave-making ants take to expanding their colonies. These miniature tacticians of assault employ several astonishing strategies. One of the most common methods is distraction, the scourge of ant colonies. They send out scouts to reconnoiter the enemy's territory in advance. After discovering vulnerabilities, they return with this information and the army strikes swiftly, like a storm, while the main force of the aggressor colony launches a frontal assault. While many ants create a fake frontal attack, small but nimble thieves slip deep into the victim colony. Unnoticed in the chaos, they infiltrate the places where the eggs and larvae are kept. Their goal is to capture the enemy's next generation, which will become slaves in their own ranks. As a result of this tactical maneuver, the organized column returns home, carrying the next generation into subjugation. But what if the victims realize the deception and try to reclaim their offspring? The slave-making ants have anticipated this as well. They use chemical camouflage, altering the properties of their scent to sow confusion among the enemy ranks. The captured ants quickly adapt to their new environment and begin serving their captors as if nothing had happened. Seizing eggs is just one of many strategies, which conceal even more complex schemes that most could never even suspect. This world is far more complicated than it appears at first glance. And soon we will encounter intrigues hidden deeper than one could possibly imagine. When slave-making ants capture their prisoners, one of the most astonishing processes in nature begins the integration of slaves into a new colony. Despite such an aggressive beginning, this process is entirely rooted in biology. The integration begins with the spread of chemical signals pheromones, which quickly suppress the natural instincts of the captive ants and turn them into obedient members of their new communities. At first, it may seem that these enslaved ants behave like robots, but in reality they become an integral part of the complex social structure of their new home. They care for the brood, build and repair nests, gather food, and defend the colony alongside the regular members. Their role varies from species to species, but one thing remains constant. These ants play a crucial part in maintaining the functional and efficient operation of their new masters. The merging with a foreign colony goes more smoothly than one might expect. All this is thanks to the ingenious use of chemicals and powerful socialization, which even the most complex human societies might envy. These principles make us question the limits of adaptation and adaptability in the insect world. It seems that slave-making ants possess something that allows them to capture and assimilate, not by destroying, but by creating. What lies ahead in their biological machinery? After all, we've only uncovered part of their secrets. Next, we will take another step and explore the factors that ensure the success of ant warriors in their strategies of capture and integration. Slave-making ants are true geniuses of nature. Their success in attacks is not just a matter of chance, but the result of a whole range of factors meticulously honed through evolution. First and foremost, their strength lies in their ability to make the most of the tactical advantages provided by pheromones. These invisible chemical signals serve as an important tool in organizing and carrying out attacks. In addition, their colonies possess a high degree of coordination. Each ant knows its place and task, ensuring synchronized actions. However, for their campaigns to be truly successful, slave-making ants invest significant effort in reconnaissance and gathering information about the enemy. Their skill in tasting and analyzing the pheromonal status of opponents allows them to anticipate possible maneuvers and reactions, avoiding unnecessary losses. This highly organized community, using its biological skills, not only plans raids efficiently, but also knows how to quickly adapt to changing conditions. Their success is also reinforced by an exceptional ability to learn and develop new strategies, making them true experts in evolving and passing on tactics to the next generation. All these cunning techniques and combat tactics make slave-making ants unique and dangerous opponents in the insect world. And ahead, we're ready to reveal even more about the brutal methods of capture that have earned them such a reputation. When it comes to slave-making ants, the real stories of their raids can astonish even the most seasoned researcher. Imagine an army of these cunning insects moving through wooded areas, advancing in a powerful column toward their chosen victim. An example of this is an attack by Formica sanguinea ants on a defenseless colony of field ants. Observers have described how thousands of ant aggressors, like military battalions, poured into the opponent's territory. Their first strike is aimed at the colony's defenders, paralyzing them with their coordination and strength. A brutal battle erupts in the narrow corridors of the anthill, with each side struggling to hold their ground. However, the attack is meticulously planned, and the invaders push through to the center without the slightest hesitation, where the eggs and larvae are kept. Seizing the brood turns out to be a central part of their tactics, since it is the brood that will be transformed into future slaves. After the carnage, when the colony's defenses are broken, a quiet plundering begins. When a faint rustling is heard in the distance, it is the slave-making ants carrying off their spoils. A once thriving home now stands empty, plundered and deserted. These astonishing scenes might make one reflect on the limits of mutual hostility in the insect world. But the tragedy of one colony becomes the success of another. Are all doors open to these ants when they cross the boundaries of their aggression? And what could stop them from closing this chapter of conquest and moving on to new offensives? The world of ants turns out to be a continuous game of power and survival, where the rules are governed only by the laws of nature. Scientific research on slave-making ants continues to amaze even the most experienced scientists. Modern studies allow us to delve deeper into the mysteries of evolution and the social organization of these remarkable insects. Several teams of researchers from leading universities around the world are conducting detailed observations of ant behavior using the latest methods such as molecular biology and genetic analysis to decipher pheromonal signals and mechanisms of adaptation. Thanks to such research, scientists have discovered specific genes responsible for the behavioral plasticity of slave-making ants. It is these genes that enable them to quickly adapt to changing environmental conditions and seize new territories. Studying their signaling system sheds light on the unique chemical processes that occur during raids. It turns out that ants are able to alter the chemical scent of their bodies to disorient outsiders and facilitate the integration of enemy ants into a new social structure. Moreover, recent experiments have shown that the influence of social and environmental factors can significantly alter enslavement strategies. Assessing these findings, biologists are putting forward bold theories about how slave-making ants may adapt to climate change and human activity, becoming even more dangerous. As we delve deeper into these studies, we will continue to be amazed at how complex and sophisticated the system of interactions among slave-making ants truly is. The data discovered so far are only a starting point in exploring their phenomenal world. How far will ants be able to go in their quest for dominance, and what other intricate labyrinths of scientific understanding will we encounter on the path to fully comprehending their social structure? The scientific community is only just beginning to turn observations into understanding, opening the door to ever more complex questions and exciting discoveries. The history of interactions between slave-making ants and other insects has remarkable parallels with certain aspects of human history. As we look into the world of ants, we should note that the enslavement and manipulation they display share many similarities with both the past and present of humanity. Ants direct their actions with exquisite precision, relying on instinctive principles. In the past, similar tactics were used by humans for control and power. In human history, slavery existed on every continent and in every cultural tradition. Capture and enslavement, just like with slave-making ants, were not limited to military efforts alone. It was an entire system, carefully thought out, with a meticulously constructed hierarchy within society. The use of symbolic and physical force for manipulation and maintaining power has left a deep mark on public consciousness. The strategies used by ants and humans may seem different, but their goal to hold and subjugate those under control is the same. Interestingly, in ants, this process occurs purely on a chemical level, without the awareness and morality that accompany humans. However, the consequences are always similar. The resulting transformation of the community, the redistribution of roles and resources. Perhaps this conquest of the natural order has become a multi-million-year experiment in survival. In our attempts to comprehend such a complex interaction, we realize that ants can serve as a vivid example for humanity, demonstrating that the struggle for power and survival knows no bounds, even at the level of insects. But what conclusions can be drawn from these parallels when it comes to questions of ethics and morality? How far are slave-making ants willing to go in their pursuits? These and other questions make us reflect on how we, too, might reconsider our place within the complex structure of global interconnections. The intrigue lies in what awaits us next. After all, ahead is the story of systems that fight against such enslavement in the natural world. In the world of insects, where survival largely depends on cunning and adaptability, nature has provided defensive mechanisms capable of countering the aggressive ambitions of slave-making ants. Neighboring colonies of ants and other creatures have developed various strategies to protect themselves from these invaders who turn others into slaves. Some ant species, such as Formica fusco, have developed the ability to recognize threats early. They are able to alter their pheromonal signature to confuse invaders and make their colonies less attractive targets for attack. In addition, there are ants equipped with the ability to form defensive alliances. These interspecies coalitions combine their strengths to jointly repel enemy invasions. When faced with a threat, the colonies unite and attack together, creating a powerful barrier that is difficult to overcome even for experienced slave raiders. Relying on collective effort, ants also use chemical signals to warn each other of approaching invaders and to initiate defensive actions on all fronts. Other insects, such as certain species of wasps, actively defend their territory, preventing ants from taking over their offspring. They create physical barriers and reinforced security systems, turning their nests into impregnable fortresses. It is also worth mentioning various plants that enter into symbiotic relationships with peaceful ants. The exchange of nectar and shelter for protection against unwanted guests allows us to see nature's biodiversity at its finest. Nevertheless, despite all these protective measures, the world of slave-making ants continues to be filled with intrigue and tests of nature's boundaries. Soon we will move on to studying the large-scale consequences that such confrontations have on the surrounding ecosystem and biodiversity. Slave-making ants have a significant impact on the ecological system and biodiversity of the regions they inhabit. When these ants capture the colonies of their neighbors, they alter the structure of existing communities. The loss of species that have been displaced or enslaved leads to a decrease in biodiversity, which can disrupt the delicate balance of nature. The disappearance of certain species can trigger a chain reaction of changes affecting many organisms living in that environment. For example, a decrease in the number of certain ant species can affect plants that rely on these insects for seed dispersal or protection from pests. Some plants may be left without their main defenders, which in turn makes them more vulnerable to attacks by herbivorous insects. This disruption of interconnections can mark the beginning of serious ecological changes on a much larger scale. Moreover, slave-making ants that have taken over the territory may increase their numbers, which intensifies competition for resources such as food and nesting sites. Such a redirection of resources leads to a significant reduction in opportunities for other insects and small animals to thrive in this area. Such changes in the ecosystem do not go unnoticed by all its inhabitants, right up to the largest predators. Taking all this into account, studying slave-making ants allows us to glimpse the complex relationships between species and understand just how fragile an ecosystem can be under constant external pressure. The question remains whether we are able to predict what the ecosystem's subsequent response to these anthropogenic interventions will be. Very soon, we will move on to a deeper analysis of what predictions we can make about the future of slave-making ants and their place in our shared environment. When the dust settles and we look back at everything we've discovered about slave-making ants, one thing is clear. These creatures are a remarkable example of adaptation and ingenious survival strategies. Their ability to efficiently integrate captives into their colonies and use biological signals to control and manipulate raises many questions, but also provides important clues. As environmental conditions and the impact of human activity change, slave-making ants demonstrate incredible adaptability. Scientists suggest that their behavior may evolve to cope with new challenges and potentially expand their habitat range. This ability to adapt inspires both admiration and concern among biologists. After all, such changes could lead to unforeseen consequences for ecosystems. Science warns us about the importance of carefully observing and analyzing the behavior of these insects. In the future, they may become even more sophisticated in their methods of enslavement, which will undoubtedly impact the natural world around us. However, these studies also open up new perspectives in understanding social structures and survival in nature. It is important to understand that studying slave-making ants provides a valuable opportunity to see how nature addresses issues of power and subjugation. And although their world may seem far removed from ours, possible analogies with human society make us reflect on how justice and survival are intertwined in our own world. What role slave-making ants will play in the future remains an open question. However, one thing is clear: they serve as a reminder of how quickly nature's balance can shift and how important it is to interact wisely with our environment.